estate show, the show that gets you India's best property deals and also gets you to meet your developer. This week we're meeting up with Kumar Gera of Gera Developers, and he's also the chairman of CREDAI. Now CREDAI is the organization that's fighting very hard for a service tax rollback because they're saying it's really going to hurt the sector. Let's take a listen. CREDAI is hoping to get a rollback off on service tax. How hopeful are you, and what's the kind of impact that you see of this newly levied tax on demand and supply?
Well, there are many issues in the questions you've raised. I think the first thing is that we are hoping that it will be reconsidered. We are hoping it will be reconsidered for the simple reason that it is going to be a cost push. Mm-hmm. On the one hand, the government is constantly saying, let's look for ways and means to bring down housing costs, that more people in the country have housing. And on the other hand, there's a continuous pressure on increasing the taxes, duties, levies on the purchase of homes. Mm. Now, let's make no mistake about it. This is a burden on the home buyer in the country, whether he's buying a 5 lakh rupee apartment or he's buying a 5 crore rupee apartment. Mm. It is a burden, clearly. Mm. In the manner in which it is proposed in its present form. Mm. In the manner in which it is proposed, I see a lot of issues that will lead to question marks, litigations, and lack of clarity.
You mentioned that it's only in India that you have to pay stamp duty and now service tax as well. Right. So,
see, I've been in this line now for 35 plus years. I've always believed that I'm transferring a property completing it on behalf of somebody, which is why I pay stamp duty, or the customer pays stamp duty and registration. Mm. Now you're telling me that no, you are also providing a service. So am I? Do I fall? Does my activity of developing real estate or building homes, is it leading to a transfer of property under the Transfer of Property Act, or is it providing a service? If it is a service, then why do you charge stamp duty and registration?
Still ambiguity on how much service tax has been levied.
Of course, it will be ambiguous because there's a method of calculation and it's going to vary, and different people will adopt different practices. The other most interesting thing about this is that in different parts of the country, in the different states of our country, there are different practices of real estate development. In some states, there's only one agreement which is made to a flat purchaser where he pays for the land and the construction, and it's one consolidated agreement. Mm. And in some states, it's two agreements, one for land and one for the construction. And in some cases, there are three agreements, one for infrastructure, one for land, and one for the construction. Mm. So everywhere, we are going to have different methodologies, litigations. Mm. There are going to be officers who will decide things as they see the law. And there'll be the customers who will just have to pay it. Mm. There'll be the builders who will have to collect it and deposit it. Mm. And it's just going to be, an unnecessary charge.
Let's move on to another topic that the government has been dabbling with for quite some time now. It's the Real Estate Regulator Bill. Mm-hmm. Well, we've been hearing the government talk about it, and the developer community and the government has been going back and forth on how much should the bill actually be regulating, what should the details be like. How hopeful are you that it's really going to take form anytime soon? And what should the bill, according to you, seek to regulate, as in what are the areas that it really needs to look at?
Our suggestion from CREDAI is that the industry needs to be regulated not just at the level of the developer. Hmm. The developer undoubtedly needs to be regulated, but to make a real estate development project successful, there are three or four agencies who are critical. Hmm. Otherwise, it's a failure. Now, who are those? The developer, undoubtedly. Hmm. He needs regulation. The financing agencies, because they make commitments to finance the purchaser and to finance the developer. They must not back out midway. Hmm. Then there is the local authority. The local authority takes taxes, takes development charges, and they are obliged to provide the roads and the water supply and the power and other infrastructure. Mm. They must be regulated. Mm. And last but not the least, the customer. The customer who book individually or in groups, they make commitments to pay. Mm. They must pay on time. You see? Mm. It's only when all these four perform.
So you want the customer also to be regulated?
Of course.
Okay.
If the customer behaves in a delinquent, irresponsible manner, and a group of customers starts behaving like that, the whole project gets into trouble.
Right.
So therefore, any kind of regulation that we have is good regulation if it covers all these four. If you're just going to go say the builder should do this and, you know, 6 months for this and 12 months imprisonment for that and the other, you're not going to really get anywhere. The objective should be regulate the players, make sure they perform as they're supposed to, and then you'll get the results.
Let's move on to your group now. What can we expect from the group? You've largely focused on luxury. Luxury housing space and, of course, commercial.
We've always followed a rather conservative approach in this business. We've believed in slow and steady. That's been a philosophy which we've lived with. That's why we've never got caught in the boom or bust. And sometimes you miss opportunities because of that, but sometimes you gain also. So our focus has been on being innovative, to create new concepts. And we're very happy doing our business without going for an IPO, without going for public funding, and doing it in the three cities in which we are in, which we know very well, and, you know, we'd like to just grow there.
So do we look at, do we see you getting into affordable housing as well?
We are in affordable housing even currently. Affordable housing has become like a catchword, and it's like a trend, and I don't think that... it means different things to different people.
Absolutely.
So when you say affordable housing, if you mean that we're looking at housing at lower price points, then certainly, but we are looking at what that location caters to, what is this market segment that is suitable for that location. We are determining the product based on that.
Okay.
We're not determining it on the base that there must be a jacuzzi in everyone and there must be, you know, air-conditioned gym and this and that. No. It may be in certain cases if your location demands it. And in certain cases, you get a different location. So it has to be location-centric.
Fair enough. All right. Thank you so much,
pleasure,
Mr. Gera,
nice
for coming down today and
talking
to us. Thank
nice
you so much. Well, if you have any question that you would like us to ask your developer, just send it to us on realestate@bloombergutv.com. And you can catch this interview and all the other stories by logging on to our website. That's bloombergutv.com. Value-added tax to be very aggravating tax for home buyers in Maharashtra. More on that in just a bit.